potential red wave just got a big boost. The latest Gallup poll shows that 45% of Americans now have a favorable view of the Republican Party. That's up 9 points from last year's poll. This says Republicans' most positive image. It's the best image for them, according to this poll, since January 2011 when it hit 47%. That was after they took control of the House in the midterm elections of 2010. 44% give the Democratic Party a favorable rating. Now to discuss, Chris Wilson, GOP pollster, and Ned Ryan's back with us as well. Chris, I got to tell you, I was shocked when I saw this number. And by the way, I'm not a big poll guy, no disrespect, but I do like the work from Gallup. I do like the work from Pew and some of these other establishments, and Rasmussen as well. I think this is an amazing shocker, and it underscores the fact that maybe the media is calling a blue wave a little bit too early.
Well, I certainly think they're calling a blue wave a little bit too early, but it is encouraging. I think what it sees is the Republic taking a notice of what Republicans have done, taking notice of tax cuts, taking notice of border security, taking notice of trade deals that are starting to come together, taking notice of national security issues where the president is negotiating deals with other countries that are getting us out of the challenges that were created under President Obama. But having said that, I'm fearful when Republicans start to talk about a red wave too early. Because the one thing that's most important here that this poll does not reflect is enthusiasm amongst Republicans. Yes, you can have a good feeling about Republicans, but if you don't turn out and vote in November, it's kind of irrelevant about how you feel. And that's where our work, I think, is important to note here, because we are doing tracking in a lot of Senate races and governor's races on a nightly basis. And what I've seen over the course of the last week is Republican enthusiasm starting to increase. So that does give
me confidence. What's driving that, Chris?
Well, it's different things in different states. I happen to be in Austin, Texas right now, and I can tell you that there is a lot of enthusiasm around the reelection of Governor Abbott and Senator Cruz. And frankly, there's been a lot of negative reactions of late to Senator Cruz's challenger, Beto O'Rourke, and some of the comments he's made about the national anthem and now about police officers being the new Jim Crow. And I think all of those are kind of leading to feelings here. But I could give you examples like that in Arizona, Nevada, Montana, North Dakota. And I think the Republicans.
I want to come back to you and ask you about an incident with Ted Cruz, but let me bring Ned into the conversation. Ned, a lot of discussion over the last 30 days or so on how the Republicans go at the midterm. How do they package their message? What do they focus on? A lot of polls are showing sort of being victims of their own success on the economy. It's down to 12 points in another Gallup poll because it's doing so well. People aren't as concerned about it. So what does this poll tell you, and how do you message it?
Well, there are a couple things. First of all, I totally agree with Chris. Don't count your chickens before they hatch. Republicans are going to have to work hard. I mean, they're going to have to defy historical trends to keep the House. There's three things, Charles. If you look at a poll that was done about 10 days ago by the Club for Growth of 40,000 likely voters in 41 swing districts, there were three issues that were important to these likely voters in these districts. The first one is they want to hear what Republicans are going to do if they keep the majority. What are they going to do in 2019? The most important issue to them, they have to make the middle class tax cuts permanent. But I thought what was interesting, Charles, was when it came to likely suburban voters who were still persuadable, there were two issues. One, they responded very negatively to the Democrats talking about abolishing ICE, and they responded very positively to Republicans saying we're going to defund sanctuary cities. And then if you look in the rural districts, they responded very strongly to the idea of Trump being impeached.
Right.
And so it really is district by district. But
right.
I think the most important thing Republicans have to do is put forth a compelling message. Here's what we will do if you give us the majorities in 2019.
Chris, you mentioned that Beto O'Rourke and maybe pushing this envelope too much, you know, the sort of, running on race, separation of race and social injustice. And this incident that happened with Senator Ted Cruz and his wife at a Washington, D.C. restaurant, they were chased out of there. How does that impact an election?
Well, first of all, I do want to say that had nothing to do with Congressman O'Rourke or anything related to his campaign. But I do think what it points to is a level of divisiveness that is occurring in our politics that is unfortunate. But I would also say that right now that only seems to be coming from one side. And I would say the same thing
Does that help or hurt Ted Cruz?
I don't know that it's really relevant. I think what it does show is it shows that the Democratic Party is becoming unhinged, and it's becoming the Democratic Party. It's why you're seeing those kind of numbers from the Gallup survey,
right,
in which people are looking at Democrats and say that does not represent what I believe in.
All right, guys, we've got to cut it short there. We got breaking news. I will say there's a Wall Street Journal NBC poll that has a major double-digit lead for generic Democrats over Republicans. I have breaking news right now. The Senate Judiciary Committee has set a